Good afternoon. Thank you for the nice introduction. Today we are talking about a very important topic in our country: hypertensive disorders in pregnancy in Ghana. So somebody will ask, why do we still talk about it? I will start with a very hard touching but a success story. This was an elderly woman who had tried several times to get pregnant. Luckily, she got pregnant after several treatments. Then, around 8 months into the pregnancy, she started having severe headaches, so she reported at a nearby clinic. When she got there, she was told her blood pressure had gone so high, and so she was referred to our hospital here. As soon as she got here, she lost consciousness completely. She collapsed, and that was the end of the story. For 4 days, she was unconscious, and most of us thought it was not going to be possible for her to survive or to gain consciousness. Lo and behold, she really responded well to the treatment and became conscious at the 4th day. And when we had opportunity to talk to her and ask her a question, this is what she had to say. So touching. And she said, "When I got here, I didn't see anything. I was here for 4 days before I became conscious. The most difficult aspect of my delivery was when I became unconscious for 3 days, and I didn't know what was going on around me." This is very sad. This was a woman who nearly died, but for an intervention, she survived. Somebody will ask, why are we talking about such women? The reason is that this woman nearly died. There are other women who also go through similar pathway. However, for some of them, they are not able to make it. But for her, because of the intervention at the right time, she survived. Studies have shown that when one woman dies, which is related to pregnancy, about 15 of them go through similar pathway. And so you can see that the maternal mortality is high, basically because of some of these things: hypertension in pregnancy. So let's look at this slide, and you can see that maternal hypertension is causing so much deaths, and because of that, maternal mortality in our country is so high. You realize that maternal mortality is the only health statistic of which there is so wide a disparity between the developed country on one side and the developing world on the other side. So, for instance, in the developed world, you can see only 16 deaths per 100,000 live births, compared to the developing world, where we have about 230 maternal deaths per 100,000 live births. In our country now, our maternal mortality ratio is quoted around 350. This is unacceptable, and we must do something about it. Most of these causes of deaths are due to hypertension and hemorrhage. Studies done in our country in the major teaching hospitals indicate that maternal hypertension has actually overtaken obstetric hemorrhage in causing maternal deaths, and that is the reason why we are here today and we need to look at it. So the main aim of this review was to find out the main risk factors for maternal hypertension in pregnancy, and also to determine the major complications of maternal hypertension. And we think that when we're able to get this, that we will be able to develop the right interventions to help with the management. And what did we find? We found out that maternal hypertension is prevalent in our country. In Kulebu Teaching Hospital here, where we all work, 1 in 5 women who present at the emergency actually have hypertension in pregnancy. And most of these have complications. We need to look at it. You can see that the red one shows that that is for preeclampsia. Preeclampsia is a prototype. That's the classical type of hypertension in pregnancy, and that causes so much complication. Followed by gestational hypertension in terms of complications, and then chronic hypertension. And in this study, we determined that there are 4 main factors that are associated with hypertension in pregnancy. Extremes of age, women who are younger and who are elderly and they are pregnant, women who have never been pregnant before and they are getting pregnant for the first time. Apart from that, women who have history of preeclampsia or previous hypertensive disease is a factor, and those with multiple pregnancies. So you see that we then move on to see the complications. And let's look at the complications. You realize that eclampsia and convulsions are one of the major complications. Most women die of convulsions or eclampsia. Acute renal failure is another complication. And then pulmonary edema. Edema related to the lungs, they can die easily. And stroke. And then lastly, cardiac failure. These are the major complications of hypertensive disorders, which cause most maternal death. And I'm sure some of you will be asking, why do we allow them to get that kind of complication? The answer is simple. This is because we have challenges in managing these women. And let's look at some of them. The first challenge, as you can see, is poverty. Poverty, poverty. In our part of the world, there's so much poverty that most of our women do not work, and then they are not really having any medical insurance. Most of them don't have medical insurance. And so when they are sick, they cannot go to hospital. They will sit until the complications arise before they find ways to go to hospital. The second thing, as you can see, is the 3-delay model. With this 3-delay model, you can see that the woman does not have the chance to decide when to go to hospital when there's a complication. This decision is always taken by the head of the family or the husband, who may not be there. Let's move on from that. Even when the decision has been taken, I tell you, we have problems with transportation. Transportation is a big problem. Sometimes there's a lot of traffic and a woman with an emergency cannot be taken to the hospital immediately. Let's look at other things. Sometimes we don't have the right system. When they get to the hospital, the third delay, the systemic delays is also a factor. Even when we have come to the system, other problems we have is lack of drugs, laboratory care. We don't have intensive care units, and so when they have severe disease, we cannot treat them well, and therefore they could die. So you can see we have a lot of challenges that affect us. So in moving forward, we have talked about the problems of hypertension in pregnancy, the fact that most of our women die of it. We have discussed the risk factors, and then we have also talked about the challenges associated with hypertension, which will cause our women, most of them, to die. So as we move forward, we need to retrain our staff, we need to expedite our referral system, and then we have to be active. There should be a dedicated team to help with the management of hypertension in pregnancy. So as we move on, we have to all know that it's a question of balance. a question of balance. Individuality on one side and collectivity on the other side. We all need to come together with the right mind, right attitude, and we can move on. So with collectivity, we can all come together and reduce the burden of maternal attention in our country. Thank you very much for your attention. We'll open the floor for questions and then we can all discuss the solutions. Thank you.